Hi, this is Amy Hayes, lead learner principal at Model Elementary School with Floyd County Schools. Finished up my Leaders of Learning summer reading today, completed a sketch note, and am going to share a summary reflection through Flipgrid. When you think of professional learning communities, we have to step back and ask ourselves, what is the foundation upon which our learning communities built? We have to have an expectation. And successful PLCs are built on the fact that all students learn at high levels. Now, with a PLC at Model last year, we created a schedule known as Terrific Tuesday, in which all teachers, kindergarten through fifth grade, were provided with 90 minutes of uninterrupted professional learning time to get together and to focus with their grade levels on the content and the students that they were teaching. We're going to go a step further this year with Leaders of Learning, as Leaders of Learning, both as administrators and as teachers. Now that we have our teams in place and we have a schedule that is protected, our Terrific Tuesday, we're going to focus on clarifying the work, using our PLCs to really dig into proficiency scales as the driving force in monitoring progress in an ongoing process through formative assessments. One of the areas that we've struggled with is really equating standards to proficiency. And through Leaders of Learning, Marzano and DeFore both gave great examples of how to move from simpler context into the target objective or the learning target toward more complex content. In doing so, that simpler content is going to be on a proficiency scale of a 2.0. Moving on towards the target objective, or once the student has shown proficiency of the actual learning target, being considered a 3.0. And if that student is able to take their learning and apply it outside of the context of what has been taught in the classroom and learned in the classroom, that equates a 4.0, being able to apply it into a more complex content. Learning progressions are important in a PLC, breaking that mastery into clear, specific, and achievable goals. If we can take this blueprint in a collaborative manner and move our PLCs towards a focus of proficiency scales and really looking at what does proficiency mean, bringing that back each week as collaborative teams, we're going to be able to look at the work and really find out who is responding to our instruction, who's getting it, and then asking ourselves, what are we going to do to enrich and extend the learning for those students? And then for those students who aren't getting the learning from that week or the previous week, what does response to intervention or response to instruction need to look like? What are we going to have in place that guarantees that we're going to be covering the material that those students need to close the gaps? And we can do that through our professional learning communities, coming together collaboratively, holding each other accountable, and celebrating. And not just celebrating, but at times, if we have a teammate who's not pulling along the way that they should, professional confrontation when necessary. Hopefully not needed, but if so, that is part of the professional learning community process. So this year, as we look at 2018 and 19 at Model Elementary, we're going to guarantee a viable curriculum, put a great professional learning community in place, and really dig into proficiency skills as we look at student work and celebrate together. Have a great year. We are Model.